Today we are starting with another topic we call glycosuria. Now you know it is either called glucosuria or you can call glycosuria. Glucosuria or glycosuria. So urine examination is very important. We'll be discussing the four headings: definition, etiology, clinical features, and investigation. By definition, we say glycosuria means abnormal excretion of glucose in urine. There are two commonest causes. One is increased blood glucose level, we call as hyperglycemia, and one of the most common cause of hyperglycemia is diabetes mellitus. And second condition, where blood sugar level may be absolutely normal and person shows presence of sugar or glucose in urine, and that we call as a renal glycosuria, and it is because of decreased renal threshold. This is a diagram which is showing you a condition we call as renal glycosuria, or we also call renal glycosuria dysfunction. Now sugar may be detected by a Benedict test, and in that Benedict test you can detect reducing sugar, because Benedict solution contains copper sulfate, which will detect glucose, galactose, fructose, lactose, pentose, and maltose. But sucrose will not be detected. Galactose, fructose, lactose, and pentose and maltose are not included in glycosuria. False positive test can be because of ascorbic acid, because of presence of high level of creatinine or uric acid, or even presence of salicylates in urine, sometime even periamino salicylic acid or isoniazide, sometime even in presence of contrast and glucuronate. This gives rise to reduction in copper sulfate, which gives a false positive results. If you do a glucose test by means of a dipstick, it will be able to detect glucose, which can be detected as a trace 1 plus, 2 plus, 3 plus, and 4 plus. When it is 4 plus, approximately we say that there is 2000 milligram present in deciliter. Glycosuria, most common cause, diabetes type 1 or type 2, JDM, that is gestational diabetes mellitus, LADA, that is latent autoimmune diabetes mellitus in adult, MODY, maturity onset type of diabetes in young, and we call secondary diabetes. Secondary diabetes can be endocrine or because of drugs. There is another condition we call as elementary hyperglycemia, where after taking high carbohydrate diet, sugar is absorbed very rapidly from GI tract, which gives rise to severe hyperglycemia. Renal glycosuria, we have already told you that renal hyperglycemia. False positive result can be there because of presence of maltose, fructose, galactose. Reagent strips can give you false positive results if there is detergent, peroxidase, or strong oxidizing agent present, or it will give you a false negative results even if there is ketones or urine is having high specific gravity, or if there is a not proper preservation of the strips. Hence, this has to be done with caution. There should be no contamination. Test strips should be kept in a container which should be tightly closed. It should be stored in a cool place, and don't use a strip which is discolored. And you have to see the result within 30 to 45 minutes after urine collection, which is done after drinking water. And when you see an abnormal finding, it is in favor of a diabetes mellitus or maybe another causes. So you should try to rule out interfering factors. Sometimes even drugs which reduces can interfere. And always look at the expiry date on a strips bottle. Best way is to detect by a Benedict's reaction. Take 5 ml of Benedict's solution in a clean test tube. Boil it for 3 to 5 minutes. If it doesn't change color, then you add 0.5 ml or we call 8 drops of urine. Boil it again for 2 minutes. Allow it to cool and now see the color. If it is same color, that is we call blue color, there is no sugar. If it is green color, it shows you 1 plus sugar. If it is yellow color, it is 2 plus sugar. If it is little reddish tinge, 3 plus. And if it is a brick red, 4 plus, which suggests more than 2 gram per deciliter. If after boiling Benedict solution for 3 to 5 minutes, if it changes color, then discard the test tube. Use a fresh test tube, clean it properly and use a Benedict solution. Or take a fresh Benedict solution. Green precipitate will give you roughly a figure between 0.5 to 1 gram. Yellow precipitate will give roughly between 1 to 1.5, that is 1000 milligram to 1500 milligram. Orange will be between 1500 to 2 gram. And results should be seen only after cooling. There is another test called as a Fallis test, which is done by potassium tartrate, potassium hydroxide and sodium potassium tartrate. There is a test for acetone, we call Rothera's test. This test will show you a purple color ring on the top with nitroprusside. This is positive when acetone is present in urine, which will be present in case of diabetic ketoacidosis and in a case of a person who is having a prolonged fasting. There is another test for ketone bodies, is called Gerard's ferric chloride test. There is another test for ketone bodies we call as a beta hydroxy butyric acid test. And ketone bodies can be present in case of diabetic ketoacidosis, prolonged fever, anorexia nervosa, gastrointestinal disturbances, prolonged fasting, starvation, severe vomiting, and we call hunger strike, like Anna Hazare. This ends with glycosuria.